Hi, welcome to the industry analysis video for your strategic level case study. And now we'll have a look at the industry in question. And when we look at the industry, we'll be aiming to look at what the industry is like, some of the key trends the industry is facing right now, risk, and even what the future of the industry holds. Is the industry going to grow? Is it going to decline? Or what are some of the key aspects of what the future is going to look like? Also, throughout this video, we'll look at some key inputs, key facts you could incorporate in your answer. Why is this important? This is very important because in the CIMA examination, if you incorporate industry examples, you show the examiner that you understand the industry in question well, some of its key dynamics, this will definitely make your answer more credible. So let's jump into the presentation. So the industry overview. So I wouldn't be reading through each and every bullet point, but I will be highlighting some of the key features. And of course, this document will be available to you for you also to have a look. So the industry in question is the video gaming industry. So this industry is not too distant to most of us. Most of us are well familiar with this industry. We play some sort of maybe mobile games, video games. So we know this industry. So this industry caters to the recreational needs of users by providing different types of games. So how could these games be played? These games could be played using either a mobile phone, a personal computer, or even a gaming console. And over the years, the industry has really, really grown. And because of this, games today have started to simulate reality. That's how close or that's how advanced the industry has become. And in terms of the users, in 2021, it was estimated that around 2.9 billion video game players existed in the world. So that's a huge number when you compare with the total population of the world. Also, in terms of region, the Asia-Pacific region was estimated to generate the most amount of revenue. So we'll go into more detail as we go on. So now looking at the segmentation. How do you segment? You can segment it by the type of device used. Are you using a gaming console like a PlayStation, an Xbox? Are you using your personal mobile phone? Or are you using your laptop or your computer, your personal computer at home? Also based on the game the type, are you playing online games or are you playing offline games? And also based on region. So now, let's have a look at some numbers. So you can see that the video game type-based segmentation, in terms of revenue, the greatest revenue is contributed through mobile games. So this is expected because playing video games through a mobile gives users greater convenience. They could play it on the run. They could play it while commuting. So that's definitely one of the reasons why mobile games lead in terms of revenue contribution. So what's important is you in this industry should understand after having a look at this that video games played via mobile phones is very popular. So you should be able to suggest, you should be able to recommend that PixelWiz uses this strategy to get more and more users to use our video games. In terms of regional segmentation, the Asia-Pacific region dominates with a contribution of 48%. And in the Asia-Pacific region, you have China. China forms the largest contributor of industry revenue around the world. You can see it's a huge share made by China. And in terms of the second highest contribution in terms of regions, it's North America with a 19% share. So what's interesting is the Asia-Pacific region dominates greatly because they contribute almost 50% of the world's revenue share. And the second highest is North America, and yet they contribute only 19%. Also, individual contributions made by some countries are also shown. So you can see China is the largest contributor, then you have United States, and then you have Japan. Market drivers and trends. Again, I'm going to highlight some of the key drivers and trends. So first, we'll see, it's important to note that the first bullet point shows us that the industry is expected to grow at a compound annual growth rate of 12.9% between 2020 and 2027. So this tells us that the future of this industry is optimistic, is positive. Over the coming years, the industry is going to grow by around 12.9% every year. That's what market analysts have predicted. What's likely to back the industry growth? One key thing is the rise in disposable incomes, especially in the APEC region, because countries like China have experienced rapid economic growth. And with this rapid economic growth, consumers have seen a higher income and their ability to spend has also increased. Other factors that have also supported the industry's growth is growing internet usage. So today, people use internet much more than a few years ago. Almost everyone has started using a smartphone. So therefore, you could see how using a smartphone, how having internet could mean that now video gaming providers could easily enable more users to play their games on the go. So that definitely has led to the industry growing and is expected to increase even further over the coming years. Also, another reason for the growth is because through the years, different video game players have developed different genres of games. So it's action games, to puzzles, to role-play games, to games that simulate your real life. So this has had the ability to attract a wide range of customers or a wide range of users. So if you are not into one game, you're likely to like another type or another form of game. So therefore, this too has attracted a lot of users and is expected to attract more in the future.